In this video, we're going to go over some of the best screen recorders for your computer system, whether you're using a PC or a Mac. Hi, my name is Adam from adamprizer.com, and if you're interested in growing your personal brand and influence online, consider clicking on the subscribe button and click on that notification bell. So you might be wondering, who am I to be making these recommendations on screen recording software? Well, here's my other YouTube channel. This is where most of the action is. You can see the channel right now has almost about 50,000 subscribers. It's got about 300 videos, and they are all screencast style videos. Now, that might seem like a small subscriber amount. However, it's a highly engaged group of subscribers. Every single video that I put up will receive, I mean, you can see right here, this was a month ago, 20,000 views. This was 5 days ago, 7,000 views. It's a highly engaged audience that I have here on this channel. So I do have a little bit of experience, and I have used pretty much all of these softwares. So I'm going to go over some of the best ones for all the different types of scenarios that you might be in. So first, let's talk about for the Apple and Mac users. I'll let you know that I am a Mac user. I've been a Mac user for a very long time. Let's go ahead and take a look at some of those apps for the Mac. So the number one software for the Mac that you're going to hear people talking a lot about is Screenflow. And you could just Google Screenflow and it'll pop right up. Screenflow is really good. I started on Screenflow, as a matter of fact. Ooh, looks like the price just went up. It used to be $99. It looks like it's $129 now. Screenflow is fantastic. Screenflow is just a Mac app though, and I personally use this software for maybe, I'm thinking about 200 of those 300 videos that I created on my other YouTube channel. It is fantastic. And with an app like this, and also the next one that I'm gonna talk about, it has all those type of screen recording features that you want, where after the fact you can make the mouse cursor larger, you can have click effects, you can blur things out, you can resize things, you can do a lot of neat things like that. What's really neat about Screenflow version 7, which came out not that long ago, is you can also record and edit in 60 frames per second. Now, the next Mac app is the one that I've been using probably for the most recent 100 videos, and that's going to be Camtasia. Camtasia used to be crap. I never liked Camtasia, but then they came out with Camtasia version 3 for the Mac, and it was a total rewrite from the ground up, and it was really, really good. It provided some additional editing options that I was after, so it made me make the jump from Screenflow to Camtasia. Another benefit was there's also a PC version of Camtasia, so I could take my project file and I can edit it on a PC or a Mac. There's a couple features that would be removed though from going from the transition, but probably about 95% of those features are going to be there and available to you. So this is Camtasia. Camtasia is probably like the creme de la creme for screen recording softwares. It's going to run you about $200. You definitely want this if you're serious about screen recording on your computer. So next, let's go ahead and take a look at some apps for a Windows or a PC. Now that's going to bring me right on back to Camtasia. It's probably the best that is out there for a PC, and it's going to run the same price, the $199. It's really good, and you know, it's done me really well. It's done me really well. The only thing I don't like about Camtasia, though, I will let you know, is that it takes forever once you've edited your video. It takes forever to export it to a file that you can then upload to wherever you want it to go, to YouTube or whatever. Now I want to share with you a little secret, and that is I'm not using any of these softwares anymore for any of my screen recordings. I am now using something that I never even considered for what I do before, but after some things that have happened over the past 2 months, it got me to kind of open up my eyes to what other possibilities that are out there. And now I want to talk about live streaming softwares. I didn't realize that I could use a live streaming software, and I'm actually using a live streaming software right now to make this video, and I can record my videos in these live streaming softwares, because most of them will also record to a file. So you don't have to just live stream it to Facebook or YouTube. It will also make a file on your local computer. And that's what I'm using right now. And there's some benefits for that. The number one benefit for me is it's going to be a lot less time investing into actually editing the app. Every effect that you're seeing in this video, you hear the swoosh, you see the screen swipe left and right, you see the text right here on the screen. All of this is done live in this live recording software. So all I have to do is very minor cutting in and out in the video, and I can make these videos in maybe just a few minutes of editing and send them right on up to YouTube. There's a huge benefit to that. So the end result is better produced videos in less time. So let's go ahead and take a look at some of those. So the number one free live streaming software is OBS. I will tell you, I don't use OBS. When I was making my decision for the live streaming software that I wanted to use, I didn't even want to go this route. I think it's a fantastic. Most YouTubers are using OBS. It's free. You can't argue with the price. It'll do green screens, transitions, all of that kind of stuff. And I think it's a very worthy contender. Now, what you're not going to get out of using one of these live streaming softwares is you're not going to get a lot of those after effects, like increasing the size of the mouse or a mouse click effect or things along those lines. But I'm going to tell you, out of all the videos that I have made for that other YouTube channel, we're talking 300 screencast recordings here, I can count on one hand the times I've zoomed in a little bit or used any of those effects. They don't really add enough value, in my opinion, to make it a requirement that you use one of those types of softwares. And that's why live streaming softwares are very appealing to me. So we got OBS right here. This is not what I'm using, but I do think it's fantastic. The next one, I actually have this and I use this for a while. It's called ECam. Now, this is a Mac only application. It's fantastic and it's very affordable. You could do transitions. You could do the bubble effect like you see me doing right now here in this video. You can do all of it with this. You can have titles. You can have all kinds of stuff. The benefit is you take that file when you record it, minimal editing. You don't have to put all these effects after the fact, and you have a highly produced looking piece of software. Now I will reveal what I'm using. I'm using Vmix, and Vmix is the granddaddy of live streaming softwares. Now it's a PC only app, and for me, I use a Mac, but I bought a dedicated PC with a hefty graphics card just so I could use it with Vmix, but I'm able to do all kinds of stuff. You saw right here, I push a button and I've zoomed right here on the side. I push a button, I'm right here. I added the swoosh sound. I can make myself disappear if I wanted, and I can make myself come right back. I'm just pushing a little button on a keypad here, and I can do all of that with Vmix. Now, Vmix is a little on the pricey side. I mean, there's different ways of getting into it. So I'll show you what I have. Actually, where the heck is the buy button here? So I'm assuming right here, Vmix software might have our pricing table. Okay, I'm not seeing it here, but maybe if I just clicked on this purchase button, I would get that. Okay, so there's several different packages with Vmix. There's a free version, the basic HD version's $60. The version I have is $350. Now there's a 60-day free trial if you were to try this out. I'm actually in the 60-day trial, but as soon as I'm done, I'm probably gonna kick in the $350 to get the $350 package, but I'll be able to do some really neat things, including having a guest on for my videos. I'll be able to do all kinds of cool stuff like that. So this is Vmix. I'm really thinking we're entering the stage of recording software where, for me personally, I want to make the best video in as little amount of time as possible. And that's why when I started thinking about using one of these live broadcasting softwares to record my videos, it just made perfect sense to me that that's what I would use. So that is what I think are the best ways of recording the screen on your computer. But you know what? I want to hear what you think in the comment section down below. So if you've enjoyed this video or if you have any questions for me, like I said, I have experience using Screenflow, Camtasia, and now I switched to Vmix, go ahead and ask me in the comments down below. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Thanks for spending this time with me, and I'll see you in the next video.